Are recording now. G'day guys, how's it going? Blood Teeth here, and I'm going to bring you an endurance now. Yes, wizard level 633. Fields explored 130. Suffice to say, since the last video, I've gone ahead and done quite a lot of stuff. Whoops. Including doing that. Okay, let's just pretend that never happened. Okay. For a second there, I forgot how to zoom out of the map. I hate magic mice. They're not very magical for me. Anyways, I bought the magician's pouch. I went ahead and played a whole ton of levels. I've got a whole bunch of... really decent fragments, actually. There we go. If you really want to see that, just pause the video. I don't want to spend too long on it, but that's my stats for the talisman. These are my stats for the skills. There's a good reason why some of them are the way they are. Let's see. There's nothing else you need to know other than which map I'm going to play, and to be honest, I haven't really given it much forethought. I'll just replay another one, which I think is really good and nice and easy for endurance. Something that I can play. Wow, I really don't remember that one. Anyways, well, let's find one with... I definitely remember that. That was a pain in the butt until I got strong, and then it was easy. And also, this video is going to be split up into more than one video just because, well, at the end of the day, unfortunately, my screen capture recorder program, EasyVid, every time I record a long video, it decides to chop off everything that is more than 10 minutes long and yada yada yada. It's a pain in the butt, to be honest. You know what? I'm going to go nuts with the battle settings because... Oh. Yeah, that looks good. Drop rarity range 41 to 88. XP multiplier 45.7. And shadow cores, everything I've got. Yeah, unfortunately, I have to split this up into two, maybe three videos. Who knows, I might not even get a chance to finish the video. We'll see. Okay, not making any promises. Might not be able to finish the endurance. Sorry, that's what I meant to say. But, having said that, should be able to get through quite a bit anyways. Man, already I've made a mistake. Let's see now. Gem bomb that. I want to seal this off. And do this. That's what I want to do. Always start off my levels these days with a mana farm. I find it just works best to get that mana income coming in ASAP. It's also nice to have your gem in your tower up and running as well. Yeah, I didn't think I'd have enough mana for that. Oh well, no biggie. There isn't really much I can tell you other than I surged ahead. I went ahead and played a lot of fields. I've got quite a bit going right now. Let's see. I'm loving the game. I have to be honest with you. It's good fun. I've almost finished all the fields. Not quite all of them yet. Let's just upgrade this a touch more. That can reach pretty much all the way around there, can't it? Okay, I'll just upgrade it two more times. There we go. That's a good little backup killing machine. Let's see. Upgrade and put number 6 on it. Go little mana farm. Pause the game. Now let's see. 10 grand. That can get me... what? A few of those. So let's go ahead and gem bomb. And didn't send these. It's very important to get your mana farm going good guns very early in the game. And one surefire way to do that is to gem bomb the hell out of all of the wave stones and send them packing, basically. Ooh, hello. Freeze lock, hey? 1, 2, 3. Oh wow, I can upgrade that again. It's good to see. Yeah. Let's see now, what am I gonna do? Pause the game. 107,000. I'll go ahead and do this. Keep angering your waves, guys. Don't be afraid to throw a lot at it, because this mana farm, for the time that it takes for monsters to go past your mana farm and get all the way to the orb, on pretty much all maps anyways, usually you've got a fair amount of time, which will give the mana farm plenty of time to go ahead and gather up all the money you need to quickly upgrade your gem that you are firing against the monsters with. So don't be afraid to go a little bit nuts with the gem bombing. You will benefit from it greatly, I promise. Let's go ahead and do grade 6. Six on each. Oh, whenever you see this spark. Oh, no. Sorry, not that one. That's the Prism Cascade one. Or whatever it is. When you see the spark that basically ups the overall amount of, say, XP you're going to get for the game by doing something about the mana pool XP gain multiplier or something like that. Anyways, when you find that spark, go ahead and gem bomb that quite a lot. Because, let's be honest, the more XP you get, the better. Okay, mana farm's going well, but it can do better. Let's give that number 6. How many waves have I got? 126, so plenty of waves to go through before I need to smash out these shot locks. Well, maybe I should get some towers on them now. Yeah, let's do that. Just gonna surround these shot locks with towers full of nice, cheap, nasty gems. And their mission is going to be to just go ahead and attack. Let's see. Ah, oh, they reach. Alright, I'm going to make these, force these to go for structures only, the rest don't reach anything of significance. Maybe use structures, use structures, use structures. Cool. And then life is Jim Dandy. Oh, I should have taken down what time I started this video. I'm going to aim for 15 minute videos. Hopefully my recorder program won't have any complaints about that. If it does, then I'll have some complaints about it. But you won't have to hear that. How much do I need? I usually like to wait until I can upgrade my mana farm gem twice in a row. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I hate that. It just randomly comes up and ruins my life. Well, this is gonna take a while. A little tip, guys, don't do what I just did. Whenever you see the Forgotten coming up from the middle, don't go ahead and try and pause the game, because if you pause the game, when he casts his little spell on you, you've got no control of anything for as long as this spell lasts, which feels like, I don't know, 30, 45 seconds, maybe a minute on if you've got your gameplay on 1x speed, it goes past much quicker when you're on 9x speed, of course. But if you pause the game, it forces the game to unpause and proceed at 1x speed. So this is torture. I cannot do anything until the time period is over. And it's going by so slowly. I can't believe this is... Just randomly thinking, I can't believe this is 1x game speed. I mean, how slow is this? Who plays the game at this speed? If you played the game at this speed, please leave a comment below. I'm pretty sure nobody. Wonder how those shot locks are going. They've got plenty of time. Oh, come on. How slow is this? Finally. Whoa. Okay, I got some cash. More mana. Whatever. Same, same. Actually, I'm going to go ahead. What grade is this? 11. I'm going to go ahead and increase the amount of pull bound and what is this? Critical hit. Increase that in the gym. And while I'm at it, I'm going to sell these because they are useless. I'm going to move the gym, the whole thing, to here because it's a lot further away. Here than if I leave it where it is. So that way I can really upgrade it without making the range get to the point where it can actually reach the mana farm. Man, now I have to do this. Let's see, upgrade you to 12. That seems like a good plan. Chuck you all in there. Put the game on 9x speed, please. Thank you. Yeah, we've got good range, but it's nothing nuts. Which suits me just fine. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and take out all the towers. All the beacons, that is. Because they annoy me. Let's see. Okay, mana farm, don't let me down now. Shot blocks are doing fine. Everything is progressing nicely. I may have to end this video soon. In fact, I probably will. That spell from the Forgotten I can live with. That's nothing. Just goes ahead and anchors a few waves. Easy to deal with. It's the other one I just... Ugh. It annoys me. It really inconveniencing. If that's even a word. I don't think it is. Oh, just in case you haven't already caught on to the idea, learn all the hotkeys. It makes playing this game so much faster and easier. Ooh, mana game? Yep, mana game. Let's go ahead and use that stupidly. Why not? Come here. Yay, I just spent 200 and something thousand mana and got 110 back. What happens if you spend 172 mana? Oh, okay, so that's the trick. If you get these shrines, and you just want lots of mana, put in the cheap gem, and you get the same amount of mana back. So it's got everything to do with how many monsters you hit and stuff, and nothing to do with how much, like, what grade the gem is that you put in there. That only affects the damage, I'm assuming. Fair enough. Whoa, I got a lot of mana. Speaking of which, go ahead and upgrade you again. There we go, this is the one, Touch of Wisdom. I have no problems going ahead and gem bombing the hell out of that thing. I welcome it. In fact, let's go ahead and gem bomb it some more. Actually, I can't be bothered with that. Blam. Thank you. Wow, I'm getting some serious mana going now. Oh. Almost got the mana I needed. I just had a stupid thought. What if I do this and this? Put one there, one there. And now, something like that. Upgrade it to, I don't know, level 17. That way anything that comes in with shields won't have shields when it does finally hit my mana farm. This might be a stupid idea, but screw it. I'm running with it. Actually, even better, if I go ahead and do this, and then shut my mana farm down one, and then wait a second, what? Where's my trap? Oh, there it is. Okay. Sorry guys, just quickly rearranging stuff here. That's a bit better. At least now that way, everything goes over my mana gem a little bit more than if it wasn't that way. Alright, I'm happy with that. Nah. Stupid magic mouse. My bad, guys. If I had a good microphone of some sort on my computer, I would definitely record on that instead of this, I promise you. I can tell you right now, my girlfriend probably didn't like hearing that, because this is her computer. Shadow. Hello, Mr. Shadow. Come here. Oh, did I kill that shadow already? Cool. No, it doesn't look like I did. Now I have. Got him. Too easy. I can upgrade this again, actually. Yeah, perfect. It's not even a competition. I'm totally smashing these guys. Anyways, it looks like I'm going to have to pause the video here and go ahead and continue this in the next video, so I'll see you then. Oh wait, it's stupid, why should I do that? But I can just easily do this and this. So just give me a sec, I'm gonna fix this up. Get rid of that, so I can go ahead and get rid of that too. Now, since this component is in everything, why not amplifier? And at least I'll know when I'm looking at this amplifier here that the gem I would want to upgrade is right there next to it. Just use these amplifiers or towers next to my mana farm to be basically an indicator of where it all is. Sometimes it's really hard to tell with all those monsters all over the place. What's in the shard? Bugger all. Man, I don't want to end this video. But I have to. Otherwise, it's just not going to be what I want it to be. It's not going to be what you need it to be. It's just going to be rubbish. So, unfortunately, this is where I end. After I do more fiddling, yes. That'll do. Oh wait, wisdom? No. Should I stop or should I not stop the video? Wow, I'm getting some serious mana right now. Oh, hello, Spectre. Goodbye, Spectre. Inspector Spectre, you just got served. Tell you what, I'm going to try my luck and I'm just going to continue this video at least until I finish the level. Then I'll probably film the next film when I actually start the endurance. That makes sense. That seems like a good time to stop. don't understand it. These monsters are so weak. My mana farm is killing them. And that's all nice and Jim dandy, but... my poor Jim with the bloodbound here isn't really getting much of a serve. Look at this. Look at the number of hits, 61,000 as opposed to... maybe I should just merge these two, what do you say? No, we can't do that, that's silly. Towers cannot be removed. Walls can be removed, but not towers or amplifiers. So, if you really want to permanently block off a path, just put a tower or an amplifier on there. Guaranteed to work every time. Whoa. I got a lot of mana. Again. Yeah, so I decided to fiddle with the gems inside the amplifiers. Sumi, I want this thing to get some mana gain. I don't think it's much though. Yeah, no, it's not much. 303.2. And it's doing 1.5 million per hit. It's chump change. It's nothing. There's one powerful mana farm though. What have I got? 17 million. Yeah. Why not? Let's go ahead and waste a billion mana on gems for... well, angry. Why not? They still get more monsters. This should be good. Is this 31? I think I'll be comfortable when this is grade 33. That's when I can sort of sit back and relax and say, yeah, my mana farm is kick ass. How many ways? 126. Yeah, let's send them all, why not? Let's get this over and done with. So close to having the mana I needed to upgrade it again. What did I say my multiplier was? Something like 41. So I'm looking at about 2 million XP so far, which is definitely a PB for me. Like, that is a nuts amount of XP. I haven't even started the endurance yet. We're only on wave 127. That's nothing. Oh wow, and this gem is weak as. What I can do, a little tip, sell all of the gems that you have in your amplifiers except for one. Let's make him grade 23 worth a billion. Now I'm going to go ahead and upgrade this bad boy. Whoa, okay, maybe one too many. Yep, definitely one too many. I'm going to put this in there instead. There we go. Whoa. That is a lot of XP. That is not a lot of shadow cores. And those are some very average fragments compared to what I usually get. I'm going to stop the video right here, and I shall see you in the next video where I continue from here. Catch you later, guys.